Hello, my name is Alexander Grekov and I'm working at Institute of Natural and Technical Systems, Sevastopol, Russia. I will present your report, Ocean Surface State Monitoring with Drifters Array. Measurement of the parameters of the upper layer of ocean is one of the tasks of oceanology, on the solution of which the progress of a number of areas of ocean research depends on. So, the data of field measurements are used for verifying and calibrating the processing algorithms of remote meters, oceanographic models in various research problems, and in synoptic climatic monitoring of the ocean. A continuous increase in the volume of remote sensing data and increasing in complexity of the processing algorithms and improvement of ocean modeling method form new requirements for the quality and quantity of the experimental measurements. However, the complexity of the field measurement, a number of methodological limitations, for example, clouds for optical measurements, the need to take into account the orbital movements of phase and collapses in radar data, the high cost of special instruments, the installation and maintenance. All of them lead to the fact that the scientific community has an extremely small group of measurement instruments for surface velocity vector and spectral characteristic of surface waves. Often such measurements have limited accuracy and spectral resolution. In addition to the high cost of such devices, the presence of the case with large inertial mass and the insufficient sensitivity from both accelerometer and gyroscopes negatively affect the measurement accuracy. The long wavelength part of the spectrum, low amplitude swell, is not visible to the insufficient sensitivity of the sensors. The short wavelength part of the restored spectrum is hidden by the drifts along vibrations. An important feature of the proposed system is the using of really drifting measurers. This means that unlike traditional fixed pitch measuring grids, the distance between the sensors is continuously changing. In this case, the relative position of the buoys is controlled using global positioning systems, and the methods for finding the angular spectra are expanded using the limited interpolation approach. One of the distinguishing features of a measurement system is the synchronous data collection by several measurers at once. For the convenience of the manufacturing, installation and operation, each buoy is free drifting. The mutual distance between the sensors can arbitrarily vary at any given time. Such measurements on an irregular spectral grid require substantial modification of the existing algorithms for estimating angular spectrum. The necessary regularization of data can be achieved by the using the limited interpolation method. Additionally, the quality of the reconstructed spectra can be improved through the use of the neural networks previously trained on the available experimental data. Studies carried out using the computer simulation, a training sample of about 100,000 random spatial spectra, have shown positive results and will be continued as part of the proposed study. The measuring model drifter is made in the form of waterproof plastic float with diameter of 10 cm, containing inside the electronic and transceiver modules a battery and a balancing weight for stability giving. The drifter's electronic circuit is based on the energy-efficient high-performance microcontroller and includes two highly sensitive three-axis MEMS accelerometers, the gyroscope, the magneton, the GLONASS GPS global positioning module, several ports for connecting additional measurement channels, for example, temperature sensor, the information transfer module, the power supply stabilization unit, and the information storage recording unit. This configuration was tested on the early prototypes of the meter and allow lane-wide functionality while maintaining the miniature size and long battery life of the device. The presence in the controller of the hardware accelerator for the built-in discrete Fourier transfer provides the ability of pre-processing and compressing the measurement data immediately before it's writing to the memory or it's transmitting to the device, receiving device. The combination of three-axis accelerometer, the gyroscope and the magnetometer, unlike the traditional scanner with the one accelerometer, as well as the application of the optimal Kalman filtering method, all of reduce the error of the entire neutral system. Mini drifters can be equipped with two types of transceiver modules: short range based on wireless sensor network and global action based on the satellite transponder. Each type of data transfer has its advantages and disadvantages, which leads to the choice of the one or another option, depending on each specific use case. The main feature of the proposed system is the presence of several independent instruments providing the measurement of the special component of the wave spectrum. When performing experimental work, the setup schema for drifters should be maximally satisfy the requirements of the relative positions of the floats for the providing the necessary angular and spectral resolution of the wave spectrum. The number of the measurers and the special pattern formed by them play a key role in obtaining high quality data. So it was found the most optimal layout is a figure in the form of an equilateral pentagon with additional measure in the center. This shape of the measuring grid is capable of providing an angular resolution of at least 15th degree. The mutual distance between the buoys determines the spectral resolution of the measured spectrum, which is equal to the half of the wavelength between the adjacent measures in each direction. When installing the measuring drifting equipment, it's important to take into account the speed of stream structure of the surface. For the proposed measurement schema with freely drifting measuring devices, the presence of the shifts and stream determines the duration of the measurement and the quality of the obtained data. The minimum measurement time during which the drifting must be relative proximity to each other is about 20 minutes. This time depends on the maximum length of the measuring wave, determined by the wavelength of spectral peak. Depending on the proposed location and duration of the experimental work, the control of the operation modes of the devices and the loading of the measured information can be carried out directly at the place of the experiment, remotely using a transceiver installed on the shore, on the drone, on the special control buoy, with using radio wave or satellite communication channels. Deploying the system in marine environment is challenging and among many implementation problems. It requires reliable and low power wireless links between buoys and the base stations or gateways. Typically, coastal regions use technologies such as Wi-Fi or Zigbee provided the access point and host a direct line of sight. When nodes are deployed in remote marine areas, two widely used technologies are used: a mobile communication system and data transmission via satellite constellation such as Iridium. In order to be able to cover the various deployment scenarios of ours, it is necessary to appropriate technology, for example, Zigbee Wi-Fi, adequate technology when deploying a system up to several hundred meters from the coast, which limits the use in remote areas. GSM technology can be used in remote areas up to 30 kilometers, provided that there is a coverage area. However, it was paying attention of cost of data transfer since GSM technology used licensed frequencies. LoRa, one of the core LPWAN technology, gives several advantages when deployed over the sea surface. First of all, it provides a better dynamic range compared to all of the above technology due to the sensitivity of the receiver. Since LoRa uses licensed frequencies, data transfer doesn't require financial costs. In addition, the low data transfer rate and the small overhead of the transfer protocol per byte of payload can significantly reduce the power consumption of the final system, which will increase the battery life of the buoys. There are several works devoted to the transmission of data over the sea surface using LoRa technology. The experimental results showed that it's possible to transmit data over the sea surface at distances up to 30 kilometers. However, for this, it's necessary to use expensive antennas with a high gain, and also to place them at certain height above the sea surface. As a result of the analysis, we proposed modules from Chengdu Debite Electronic Technology for the transmitting information from the US using LoRa technology. This series is based on Semtech's latest generation of SX chips. Compared with the previous generation, the data transfer rate in the microcircuits can reach 60 kilobits per second. In addition, the energy efficiency of microchips has been significantly improved. Another problem is GPS accuracy. The standard GPS modules in sea conditions provide absolute accuracy 6 meters and relative accuracy 3 meters. This is quite enough for most of the tasks of studying sea waves. For example, the minimum wavelength measured using satellite is about 30 meters. The spectral resolution of the WaveWatch 3 is not less than 40 meters. The use of joint GNSS GPS modules provide an accuracy better than 5 meters. And if this is not enough, then you can use a dual band receiver, which will provide the accuracy of 30 centimeters. A distinctive feature of the developed measurement system is the ability of measuring the ambient spectra of sea waves. The mathematical basis of the estimation algorithm is based on the analysis of the Fourier difference coefficient of various measurement components, predictions of the acceleration waves, orbital velocities, and elevation of sea surface measured by wave-shaped lattice. Since the number of spatial components is usually limited, the existing data processing algorithm uses the maximum likelihood method or maximum entropy as interpolation approach. In the case of single measure, for example, a buoy with a wide base, it's possible to use the component of the measured linear along the acceleration vector for the calculating the linear spectrum. Conclusion. Based on the analysis carried out in the work, the measurement system with a synchronous data collection on information transfer from the small detectors using LoRa technology is proposed. The distinctive feature of the developed measurement system is the ability of measuring the angular spectrum of sea waves. The electrical circuits, the operation algorithms, the structural and mechanical parts of the buoy were developed and the dual mode passes preliminary tests. So the proposed approach opens a good opportunity for efficient, expensive, and inexpensive monitoring of ocean surface state without the use of satellite infrastructure, without the use of licensed frequency band. Thank you for your attention.